Hey, BrainStuff, it's Kristen Conger here. And listen, I get anxious, you get anxious. I mean, I'm anxious right now. But hey, it's a totally normal and healthy response that keeps us from doing things that might actually be dangerous, like sticking your hand in a fire. But when anxiety is so pervasive that it interferes with your daily life, it becomes a disorder. And most researchers believe that that disorder begins in your brain. There are several types of anxiety disorders. Phobias, PTSD, and OCD are just a few. But let's focus today on general anxiety disorder, which affects close to 7 million adults and is twice as likely in women. Maybe you're worried about money, health, family, or work, and despite reality, you'll expect the worst. The symptoms include restlessness, fatigue, difficulty concentrating, irritability, muscle tension, and sleep disturbances. And the symptoms officially become a disorder when you can't control your worry for at least 6 months. You may still be social, or even employed, or even hosting YouTube videos, but people with general anxiety disorder can have difficulty carrying out even the simplest of daily activities. Experts believe that general anxiety disorder is caused by both biological factors and life experiences, or a combination of nature and nurture. But anxiety is also recognized by many as an emotional response with neurobiological roots in your brain. Simply put, the neural pathways in our brain sometimes lead to irrational anxiety. And stressful situations encourage us to develop associations with those pathways by influencing which neurochemicals pass through them. The same way you learn to tie your shoes, you can also learn to be anxious. One stressful thing, like being stuck in traffic, leads you to think of another stressful thing, like a car crash you survived, activating a part of the brainstem called the locus coeruleus. This triggers symptoms of anxiety by releasing norepinephrine in your spinal cord and parts of your brain, while hormones like adrenaline and cortisol spread through your body. It's supposed to initiate an analgesic response to suppress pain and initiate defense when you're under threat, like if you were actually in a car crash and injured. But when there isn't an actual threat, all we're left with are the jitters of anxiety. Now, we don't have enough time in this episode for a full accounting of the treatments available for anxiety disorders. But you should know that only 1/3 of people suffering from anxiety are actually getting help, even though it's highly manageable. Treatment usually involves a combination of cognitive behavioral therapy, aka talking to a therapist, and medications to relieve the symptoms. Other treatments include relaxation techniques like meditation, improved nutrition, exercise, and adequate sleep. Some medications will temporarily change your brain chemistry, although some dispute that, but they're not a cure for anxiety. For that, you'll need to change your neural pathways associations by learning new behaviors through therapy. This method of learning new everyday strategies can be slow going and repetitious, but scans show that you can literally change your brain with enough practice. So, do you suffer from anxiety? And if so, how do you manage it? Let us know in the comments. And for more about brain chemistry, psychology, and total dread, make sure to visit us at HowStuffWorks.com.